guys, happy 4th of July to you guys. I'm just coming on here real quick to just share with you my hauls for this week. They have been very limited because I had to put myself on punishment, y'all, because I totally went over budget in my couponing. So, you know, we coupon to save money. And I just budget $25 a week to coupon for household items, not for groceries, but just for household items. And so that gives me like $100 a month. And so I do keep account of it. And last week when I was going through, my final tallies for June, I went over budget by $86 and some change. So I was like, no. That is not what this is about. So this week right here, I kind of like restricted myself and I would not allow myself to basically go over budget, because now that leaves me with about $14 that I can spend for the entire month of July. So later on in this video, I am going to show you my hauls that I got from various stores that I spent very little out of pocket, like less than $2. And you're going to see the things that I got. So I am at the Dollar Tree right now. I'm not couponing, but it is the 4th of July. So happy 4th to you guys. If you haven't already, I had to leave the house because I forgot to get the kiddos some fireworks. So I got these. My Dollar Tree is actually still open. It's like a ghost town around here. I guess everybody's at home with their family. My parents did come up and we had a little small cookout and they're on their way back home now. So me and one of my youngest daughters, we stepped out and I got some sparklers. And I also got these, guys. I love these things from the Dollar Tree. I got these and they're 8 in the pack. So, and it's 5 of us at home. So we're going to enjoy this tonight and the fireworks. And I also found this little photo album because I wanted to just start to make a little memory book of the things that we've been doing this summer. So this would be our summer 2018 little summer book. So anyway, guys, when I get back to the house, I am going to show you what I got this week with spending less than $2, because like I said, I made a decision that I am not going to go over budget, so I had to limit myself. And you will be amazed at the things that you can do when you put your mind to it and still use coupons in the right way, not going overboard, but using coupons in the right way and really maximizing your savings. So I'll come back and show you my couponing haul for this week. All right, guys, so I'm back home. So this is where I keep all of my couponing receipts, in this little binder. And it's, you can see it's kind of thick. I got this from Dollar General, but I keep all of my receipts in here. And one day I'll show you the little form that I use. But here it is right here, guys. So I actually spent a total of $246.43. However, if I have any refunds or I bought a credit, Saving Star rebates, if someone gives me $20 and asks me to go to the store for them to create a bundle, then I subtract that. And so that's how I got the $186.42. Which is $86.42 over budget, because my budget for the month is $100. Now, if you look at this, for the month of June, I got 202 items, and for an average of 92 cents per item. And that's a great deal, because of course I got stuff like paper towel, laundry detergent, things like that. However, if I am supposed to be saving money, I cannot go over budget like this. That's not going to be beneficial to my family. Now, I can say that the reason why I did spend a lot of extra money, because it was during the time where it was graduation season and I was trying to get some bundles together for some of my students that will be going on to college or joining the military, in the fall. So, you know, I was trying to do a lot of the deals, and also I was trying to do a lot of the Tide deals so that I could give them away to my mom and my grandmother. Okay. So
But at the same time, I cannot put my own family in the hole to help other people because charity begins at home. So with that being said, let me show you my haul that I got for this week right here. All this stuff that you see on the table. I got all of this stuff and I paid $1.51 for all this stuff that you see on this table right here. Okay. Not spending very much money out of pocket. Now, I did use a lot of points and register rewards and extra care bucks from CVS, but that's okay. It was not money out of pocket. And for me, couponing is very therapeutic in many ways. It calms me down. It, you know, it relaxes me, but it also helps me with symptoms of chemo brain. You know, so I like to go couponing because it helps me to think quick on my feet so that I will not have to be suffering from any chemo brain symptoms. All right, so let me show you what I got here. This right here was totally free from CVS. And of course, I have all girls. So I needed this for one of my daughters. And as you can see, my total out of pocket for this was zero, okay? Because I used extra care bucks for that particular transaction. I used extra care bucks. So that was zero, okay? So now then on to Walgreens. So these guys were on sale for 3 for $6. You know, the Dixie plates were buy one, get one free. And I had a coupon for that. I also had a buy one, get one free coupon for the Febreze. And there's also a saving star for the Dixie plates, but I already used mine. I think it's $1 off or $2, but I already used mine. I got these toothbrushes, and you have to get this kind right here, Oral-B Healthy Clean. Mine were $1.39, and it's buy two, get one free. Yeah, it's buy two, get one free. So by the time you do that, it's like you're paying little or nothing for 6 toothbrushes. And then I got these for my other daughter. All right, and so here is my receipt. You see the Dixie plates, you see the Oral-B toothbrushes, the Febreze, and then the Kotex, and then I use coupons. I also use some register rewards from from last week. I used from the candy deal, and then I actually had, do you see where it says W card store credit? I had some Walgreens cards with some money on it, so it wasn't cash out of pocket. And so I used that to lower my out of pocket because my total was $19.20. So with those cards, I ended up paying 38 cents. All right, and then look, guys, I got $3 back. So I can use this for next week. And I also got this Catalina that says when you spend 25, you can get 10,000 points. So I don't know if I'm going to be able to do that because I am on a budget. But maybe I can watch one of those videos that show you how you can use points to spend and then earn points back. Maybe I'll do something like that. But I cannot go over budget. So 38 cents for all this stuff right here. All of the Febreze, the plates, the toothbrushes, and the Kotex. And these were all things that I can use. My family uses. Now the toothbrushes, I'll probably either give some of those away in the bundles that I'm making for the college kids. Or I may use them just for cleaning purposes. Sometimes I like to clean with toothbrushes. I watched this other YouTuber called At Home with Nikki. If you've never seen her channel, you've got to go. She is an organizational guru. Okay. Alright, so now this right over here, guys, is Kroger. I don't know if you guys have a Kroger, but this was the deal of the week for me because I really wanted to do the P&G deal. But guys, I did not get the Tide coupons. Well, let me back it up. In the newspaper that I normally get, my little town's local newspaper, I only had one, and there was no P&G, there was no Tide coupons in there. But when I went to work the next day, because, you know, it's summertime, nobody's getting the newspaper, the coupons were in there, but I only had one set. So Kroger had the deal on the Tide where you can basically, I got all of these items for free. All I did was pay the tax. Now, I did go to brandsaver.com and I was able to print some more Tide coupons because what you can do, and the sale does not end to July the 10th, I think. You can use the digital coupon that Kroger has. It's $3 off, and you can use that coupon up to 5 times each account. And you can also stack it with your paper manufacturer coupons, making all of this free. And y'all, with this Downy, this is the huge one. Look at this. Can you see it? Where is it? Say 90. Oh, there it is. 90 loaves. Do y'all see this? So it's not the little guy. This is the big guy. All right. So today I went to Kroger and I got these. You see, I got the two Downies and I paid 34 cents for the two Downies. See, the Kroger e-coupon and then my scan coupon. And the other day I went and I got the Tide. And I got all of these items and they were 79 cents. So I got 5 of them the other day. And I think the first day I did it, I only got 2. But I don't have the receipt for that one. But all in all, I only paid 79 cents for all of them because the first transaction I did, I bought the wrong item. So I ended up having to get a refund. And so they refunded me everything. But by the time we did the refund transaction, they owed me $2. So I got the Tide plus an extra $2 in my pocket. So that's why I said it was totally free. So only thing I paid out of pocket was 79 cents the first time for, it says here, 5 items. Yeah, for the 5 items, 79 cents. And then today I went back and 34 cents. So for a grand total, right here, for everything that I got on this table, out of pocket, I paid $1.51. All right. So now with the Kroger, if you have a Kroger, when I went to the store originally, they were totally out of stock. So I did get a rain check. I went back today, even though the coupon that I had expired yesterday, July the 3rd, I asked the lady at the customer service desk, would she accept the coupon? And of course, with the attitude, she told me no. You know, I mean, rolling her neck and everything. I was like, okay, really? So I said, well, ma'am, you know, I said, I understand. I said, well, can I speak to a manager? Let me tell y'all something. Never let someone tell you no who really doesn't have the authority to tell you no, if you know what I mean, okay? So I went and got the manager. He came over. He's like, ma'am, what's the problem? So I explained to him that I had come in the other night. The shelves were clear, and now I'm back, and now my coupon has expired. Will you accept it? He said, absolutely, no problem. Went through the line. The coupon scanned it scanned perfectly. So never, never, never let someone tell you no when they don't have that authority. And you don't have to have a nasty attitude or anything. Just know your rights and stand up for yourself. So, again, guys, you can coupon to save money. Never, never, never lose the focus of the real reason why you are couponing. You're couponing to save your family money, not to be a financial burden to them. So I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you haven't already done so, please subscribe to my channel. And guys, you guys enjoy the rest of your holiday, and I will see you at the next video. Hey guys, if you're gonna do the Kroger deal, make sure that you get all of your items in one transaction. All right, I was able to do it multiple times because I have more than one account, but just do them all in one transaction. All right, happy 4th of July from my girls to you. See you at the next video.